It's gotta be against the law to look this damn good. Cause baby, I feel real good and I wish y'all would.
Welcome to another episode of Winging It. Carlos and Rod cook everything. I'm Rod.
Carlos.
And today we're gonna mess around with this new dehydrator I bought over here. We're gonna do one of my favorite things, beef jerky. Do you have beef jerky in Ecuador, or do they have it?
We probably do, but
you haven't made it before.
Tell you the truth, no, I never made one. I never eat it over there. But we got something similar that they make it like. You take the meat, yeah, cut it really nice and thin, put some salt on it, and let it dry out in the sun.
Okay, so that's similar, but it looks like today I get to be the expert, even though I've been told that he's the expert and I'm the kind of the straight man. So what we're gonna do is we have very simple ingredients. We have, the most important ingredient is the meat. You can pretty much use any type of meat you want, but it's better to use a leaner meat because the fat of the meat is what can go rancid if you store it for a long period of time, or if you plan to store it for a long period of time. So you really want to dry it out. So what I use is the top round, and I had the butcher actually cut it in strips that are just a little less than a quarter inch, and I found that's made some pretty nice jerky. We have soy sauce, and we have, let me try this, Worcestershire sauce, and then whatever kind of seasoning that you like. And of course, I like ginger. If Carlos was making it, this would be cumin. And this here is hot sauce, because hot sauce makes everything better. So Carlos is actually gonna make the marinade. So the first thing we do is we put in the soy sauce. And usually, depending on how much you make, I like to go 3 to 1. So this is about 6 ounces of soy sauce and then 2 ounces of Worcestershire sauce. All right, and then today for the seasoning I'm going to use is Montreal steak seasonings. It's one of the things we use when we make our prime rib. It's real nice with beef. We've done it with jerk seasonings, when we made jerk jerky, but whatever you really like is what you can use. So we'll dump.
How much is it here?
That's about 2 ounces. So we did about 6 ounces of, that's about 2 ounces of seasoning as well. Right. So we dump that right in there. And then ginger. Ginger is something you either like or you don't like. I love ginger, so Carlos, you just start taking it, I'll tell you when to stop.
All right,
that's good. So it's gonna have a nice little ginger bite to it, which is cool. And of course, if you like a little kick to it, I know my dad loves spice, I love spice, little hot sauce. It's like butter, it never hurts. So that's good. Okay. So we're just gonna put the beef in right there. Make sure it's covered nice. Now, you can marinate this anywhere from, I say no less than 2 to 4 hours, but I like to do mine overnight. Some people do it for a couple days. Just know the longer you leave it in there, the deeper the flavor is going to get. So what we're gonna do is put that in there, make sure it's all nice and covered so no air gets to it. We have a top that we're gonna put right on over there. And then we're gonna let this go for about 4 hours. Then we're gonna show you what it looks like, and we're gonna put it in the dehydrator. All right, Carlos, we're back. It's been about 4 hours, and you can see it's gotten darker. It smells really good. I wish you guys could smell this. So what we're gonna do now, since we're drying it out, we're gonna bring it over to the dehydrator. I got the Excalibur food dehydrator. It's supposed to be sort of the Cadillac of dehydrators. I like it because it has multiple shelves. So whether you want to do one thing or whether you want to do multiple things, you can do it. So you slide the tray right out, bring the meat over, and I just kind of shake off any excess because it helps in the drying process. So basically what we're going to do is put this in here and just kind of let it do what it do for...
What it do, baby?
Yeah, you already know.
4 hours, based on the thickness of the meat. And the house is gonna start smelling really good, or wherever you're doing it. Just be careful if you're doing garlic or something, it really can smell up the house. So slide that right in. This has that easy door that you can just put right in the front. And you literally just forget about it.
Shazam you?
For a couple hours, or for 4 hours, until the timer goes off. All right, so after about 4 hours, it smells really good in here. We're gonna open up and see how it's doing. Normally I do a lot more jerky than this. I would do pretty much fill at least 3 or 4 trays. Something to remember with this also, Carlos, is if you're only doing 1 or 2 trays of vegetables or whatever, you start from the bottom.
Bottom, not a whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team in.
and work your way up. But you need to leave the trays in. So even if there's nothing in them, just the way the airflow works. Because this one's cool. The air comes from the back and filters all the way through.
I was asking you earlier, you made it play around with fish or poultry yet?
I haven't yet. I mean, I literally just got this about a month ago. So, all right. And basically, you see it's a lot smaller.
Yep.
And that's your dehydrated product. So from here, all you would have to do is go ahead and put it in the oven at preheated oven 275. Just like I said, make sure any bacteria is done. And that's it. That's jerky. It's real easy. And the nice thing about it is you can use different cuts of meat, different spices, different levels, and it's pretty easy. I love the dehydrator.
Oh, that's really nice.